Alright, so this is a GE set. It's a nice table model that belongs to a friend of mine, and this is a copy of the radio that he grew up listening to, and he acquired it, and he's done some work on it, and it has some issues, and he asked me to take a look at it. I looked in the back and haven't found any date codes yet. But the SAMs for this thing is dated February of 67. So this has to be probably one of the last, if not the last, tube table radio chassis of this caliber that GM, General Electric, probably offered. And it's a, as we can see here, it's got the volume, tone, AM, FM, AFC switch. It's a lighted dial. Solid state tuning. So it's tube output, solid state tuner. Not stereo, but dual speaker. And while this isn't one of GE's models where they simply took the plastic radio and stuck it in a wooden cabinet, we can see the framework. You know, we can see the plastic framework in the front. You can see the dummy plate if this would have been a clock radio model. And I don't know about this. Well, I guess there could have been another screw over here that's missing. But your transformer's hanging there. And then the circuit board. Boy, that sure is weak. That's typical GE double. We don't have any support in the center for this board. And it's sagging, and we can see here that it has gotten hot. This radio, well, it looks like it was a smoker set, you know, which really doesn't affect anything, you know, at this point in its life. You know, it's not awful, but you can see that this was a smoker set, and that this thing does have a bunch of hours on it. So we're gonna plug her in and fire her up and see what it's doing. Alright, so let's switch her on and let the filaments light up, and I don't think we're gonna have any power supply problems. I got her hooked up to the variac so I can watch the current. But it's not drawing anything. We can hear her coming to life. So not much going on. Not much going on. We can barely hear. And here it's picking up something. Thank you. working on the old GE hybrid radio, and I noticed that one of these pins was loose in the board on the subboard. And of course, I got it twisted, but you can see that one's got a bad solder joint in the board here. So I decided to unsolder the board to take care of that and to check it out. And I don't know how good this is coming out, but it looks like GE must have used some kind of mechanized soldering process, like a flow soldering process on this. Because it doesn't have the normal, see the normal little blob on the bottom. So all of this is going to get reflowed. And I'm going to check out all the components on here. But before I went any further, it took me a few days to find where I put it, unfortunately. But I wanted to test the tubes on this thing, just in case. Because I've had stuff like this happen before. And the first one I pull is a 12BE6. And I have to turn the light away to see the pilot light up. But look, can you see that flashing there? Yeah, look as it warms up. First it flickered a bit, and I said, well, then it went away. So I wrapped it with a screwdriver, which, just in case you're wondering how to do that, I mean, I usually take a little something with a little wooden or rubber handle, just hold the top and just tap like that, and sure enough, this tube is shorted. So I'm going through all the tubes now to see. Now this is a General Electric tube, but made in Japan. So I mean, this has a, you know, a mid-60s radio. But this is a Japanese tube. So I'll be checking out the rest of them. Because an American GE tube, GE was still making tubes in America then. Of course, it's going to be hard to see this, but this is an American GE tube. This even says made in the USA. But anyhow, so because I work on it a few minutes here and there, I don't always have time to grab the camera, but I did get a clean 10.7 IF signal to pass from the antenna terminals all the way through to the speaker. Now the 455 was really rough. I'm pretty sure we got some silver mica going on in one of these IF cans, because it was terrible. But normally, like I said before, we got no signal passing whatsoever from the tuner. But this could definitely be a problem. I'm also going to order some new S40s silicone transistors, these dome top ones. And as long as I had to undo this thing, we're going to change those and see where we go from there. Here's another thing that I'll mention. Let me say, I test the tubes more for shorts than anything. You know, a weak tube, you know, process of elimination, substitution is the best method. You can take a weak tube out of a 1946 set or a 1966 set like this, and it might work in an early 50s. It's, you know, it's subjective. But you see this crap around the base of this tube? This was a smoker set, I can tell. And while it's not horrible, it looks to be just on this tube. This might have been pulled out of something else. But there's a residue around the base, you can see. And I don't think this thing was really cleaned all that much, because I can feel it on the sides and the lettering still there. GE tubes are real good about losing their lettering if you try to clean them, but sometimes this can conduct. I mean, I know you've seen videos of stuff that was horrible and, you know, and it worked, but I mean, this stuff can conduct, so this tube is good. This is the 35W4, but I'll be cleaning all of this off, just for the heck of it. I mean, this radio is going to be a daily driver. The owner is an enthusiast. He's not too good with transistor stuff. He does mostly pre-war stuff. Older tube stuff. Just a fun time hobby for him. But this is going to be a daily driver for him. So we're going to make this thing right. There's no reason not to clean this up while we're in there. A lot of people say, oh, it don't matter, you can leave it there, dirt don't matter. It can cause problems. It can conduct. I've seen it happen. Well, alright. Alright, and back on the little GE hybrid set. I've got the board out, and I tested all the resistors in here, and they were all within spec. None of them were dead on, but they were within spec. So I re-soldered a few things on the board, and I pulled the first transistor out, which is the FMRF amp, and I couldn't get it to check anything on the meter. Now, I bought this thing last year. It is a cheaper Radio Shack Chinese meter. I had a good Radio Shack meter that developed some problems, sadly, that I used for years, but anyhow. But even putting in a dug this out of the black hole of Calcutta back there. And there's that little guy there. It's one of these silicone transistors and nothing. Nothing. It's wide open. Just like it was checking on the meter. So that's not doing anybody any good. So we'll change that. Alrighty, we removed the second transistor out of here, which is... Goodness, which one is it? I don't even know. Let's see. What is it? Number two, the mixer. So this is the mixer. And at least with this one, we got some continuity on it. All that glare. So we'll calibrate it. Where are we at? Oh, that little touchy. This thing is old. That's close enough. Well, I guess we don't show any leakage on this one. Leave it on high gain. High gain is reading about 30 on the scale. And on low gain, we're reading about, I'd say 40 or 50. Alright. So this one should have been fine. We're replacing them anyhow. Alright, here's the oscillator, which I'm kind of doubtful it was running. And didn't show any leakage on the old send core here. And this is really more... transistors are a lot like tubes sometimes, Sometimes they can test okay, but they just don't operate properly. And this one's showing on the low scale. Oh, 70, 75. On the high scale. Oh, let's see what's going on here. That's a little jumpy, huh? Is it the switch here? Which it could be in this little thing. Who knows? Anyhow, I just wanted to point out I re-soldered one of these little coupling things that was loose. This one right here. Was it that one? No. Yeah, I think it was. This one's loose. This one back here is loose. This is the one I re-soldered here. So I gotta re-solder this one. I don't know if this will focus that close in. Let's see. See that? Whatever the soldering process they used. Not too good. I'm probably just going to reflow everything under here. You know, why take a chance? But yeah, this, we had at least three of these. I want to call them griplets, I know that's what, and that's not what they are, but at least three of those with cold joints. So, I'll put the last transistor in. I got these from Newark. They had to get them from NTE. They came in a nice package, you know. These anti-static bags with the values and the layout on the front. And, oh goodness, I'm dropping stuff all over the place. Well, everything's a mess up here right now. And, oops, Newark sends them in a little box. Anti-static tape. Packaged in between foam. So, yeah. Alrighty. We're gonna get back on the GE radio over here. You know, the YouTube people say that you should always face your audience and people want to see you talking directly into the camera. Okay, so that should gain me another 500 subscribers. Now that you all have seen me. Yay! Alright. I haven't found a practical way to test this this FM board that I put the transistors in. To test the IF transformer here. Now this is the 10-7 megacycle IF, and when everything was together, that was about the only thing that was working on here, as you could clearly hear the IF signal passing through the radio. So I'm just going to put this back in, and if we wound up having to do anything with it, it's going to be a mess, but I'm just going to follow my gut at this point and say that this is good. One thing, this little cork pad, the glue dried up and it fell off the bottom of this. So I'm going to get the little cheapy glue gun warming up, and I'm going to just put a little dab there and get this pad back on here. And then we're going to set the board back in the chassis and get everything soldered. I re-soldered a bunch more of the connections under here. I went under a magnifying glass, and I think I'm pretty satisfied. The way it looks like, and there's still a few original ones here, and what it looks like to me, if I can do this without the glare, you can see like right here and up here some of these originals. It looks like when they soldered it, they came back with something and sanded the solder blobs flat. That's the only way I know how to describe, because they were all perfectly flat edged and shaved looking. I don't know what GE was doing there, but whatever. I mean, this is standing off enough from the board. It's in, there's nothing underneath here for it to even contact to. So, and its little pad's probably unnecessary, but it was, you know, GE spent the 3/4 of a cent to put it on there, so we're going to put it back on. I have no clue what station this is, but now AM's working on this thing again. I don't know what the heck I'm picking up.
Is a production of the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services.
My grades were bad. I would like
to be doing that in my school life, but if you would see me at home, it would have been a complete.
I mean, it was just rough focusing on school when your mother is somebody you have to take care of. It got worse.
So the very first thing we had to do, assist, you know, Parish government, obviously wildlife and fisheries. We had a whole host of other sections, other local police departments, state police, and just rescuing people, make sure they were safe. Then it goes into...
So you are Jesuit trained, and you know those Jesuits, they were smart guys, and they
were
on that. Now, do you attribute some of your knowledge to them?
Certainly, yeah. 8 years with them, so,
absolutely. High School in Los Angeles.
I think the signal input's still a little low on it. We can hear the IF problems, but
despite that,
we're passing AM now. On the FM side, we're pretty much stuck on one station, or two stations that are over talking each other. One's just, it's like the K-Love Christian station, which I believe is below 92, and then 93.3 I hear talking over it. Well, that sounds like country, so that's 92.3 or 101. Oh yeah, we got some more work here, but yeah, making some progress. Alright, so I got the board back in, and some problems are better. Some haven't gone away. One thing I wanted to note on here, and this is incredible to me, but this is how GE built it. Good old GE build quality. Alright. You see this disc cap? It's backed up against this coil. It's got nowhere to go, right? Look at this. You see that? The tuning cap has been scraping into this disc cap for quite a long time. It may have something to do with some of our troubles, but basically what's going on now disco. Alright, I'm going to reshoot this real quick because I got a, with three stations talking on top of each other, I got a copyright infringement on some song from the Christian station. So let's try this again, and I'm going to make it real quick. Basically what I'm going to demonstrate is that we have multiple channels on FM with the antenna leads hooked up, so let's hook them back up and we'll do a quick demonstration of this. Hopefully I won't take my time so much this time, and hopefully I won't offend any more of the Christian musicians. Like, you could hear their garbled garbage with the local rap station and frickin' NPR coming in on top of it. But whatever.
individualist with losing your livelihood to compromise. And the author is saying that.
All right. It's got more music here, but you can hear. All right, so you hear what it's doing. That was across the whole dial. And when we have that 89.1 Christian station coming across full bleed, so I'll patch this in and that's it. YouTube copyright you. Now if we disconnect the antenna leads, there's 93.3 coming in distorted. So that's what's going on with the FM. On the AM side, where are we? Alright, on the AM side we can hear the IF, one of the IF cans, but...
This is going on right now. The new trend is...
left in the season, 10 of then 4.5 games.
Don't be told, no.
I'm Mark Menard, WWL Sports.
Potentially wet.
Soda. Yeah, soda. The strong stations are coming in plenty strong on AM. The weak stations are kind of buried. But the AM is functioning. Except for those noisy transformers. And I'm just going to go ahead and put up what I have now as a part one. Because don't know how I'm going to have to pull this FM board back off the main chassis because of the problems you saw with the FM. And I know I detailed this in another video, but another part of this video, but when I took out the three transistors that were on this board and I tested them, the RF amp transistor right here was wide open. So I'm thinking possibly something associated with this is also wide open. I mean, did they have an exterior FM antenna, which is almost mandatory if you want to use it, because there's no provisions for an internal. Well, unless it's one, which I don't think it would be on the back. I don't have the back to the radio, but anyhow, you know, could something else in here be blown up? This cap here, I believe, is the one, no. This is the cap that the tuner condenser has been scraping across for 50 years. But anyhow, I gotta go back and take this out and recheck everything around this transistor. The only thing I could really get the leads on, this resistor right here was right on target. But we'll see what's going on with that, because I'm suspecting something up.